Good afternoon. My name is Dennis Dunn. I'm from Harcourt Dunn in Durbanville. I've been an investor for basically 22 years. And today I want to talk about the difference between the stock market and the property market. I also want to talk about the cash flow and total return between stock market and the property market. So in the stock market, you need physical money to invest into the stock market. So if you want to invest in the stock market, for instance, you will need 100,000 Rand to be able to invest in the stock market when you're investing. On the stock market, you will have relatively little cash flow. So you will only get dividends from the stock market on appreciation, quarterly, yearly dividends. And then on the stock market, your returns, you will only get returns from mostly capital appreciation over a long period of time. So that's the difference between the stock market and the property market. Obviously will generate a large portion of returns via monthly cash flow from your rentals at the end of the day. The property value also appreciates over time. So over time, property has proven that it is a great investment vehicle to invest in. Property has a leverage potential to create wealth, and there's a lot of tax benefits that goes with property, like depreciation benefits. You can lower your income by deducting legitimate expenses like levies, maintenance, and then also Article 13(6). That is basically a deduction that SARS will allow you if you're an investor and you buy five or more properties, where you will be able to deduct a certain amount of the property that you purchased or allocated through Article 13 to lower your taxable income. In most cases, expenses are covered by the rental received on property. So it's also a very important point. And often, property is more resilient in troubled times. And we saw that in the first wave of COVID. We saw that property stayed stable where the investment, the stock market, went basically down and had to recover after a period of time. Also on property, banks will offer up to 100% loan to value with favorable interest rates. And then there's also a lot of other investment products that's offered by the banks on property, where you can go and borrow the money to invest in property, where you don't physically need the money to invest. You must just be able to qualify for that. But that's how you can acquire property. So what is the risk involved between stock market and the property market? So in the stock market, it can be very volatile, as I just explained to you, that pre-COVID went bang down in and then had to recover. So the stock market can be very volatile. In the stock market, you have no control over external forces like political, social, and issues like COVID-19. And then often you are at the mercy of third parties making investment decisions on your behalf. Where in the property market, rentals provide a very consistent and stable income. Even during recession periods, rentals are still payable. And even during COVID-19, we saw that the property game stayed very stable. Your value of your property is tied to inflation. As inflation goes up, your replacement value will go up on your property. And so also will your rental demand go up on your property. In the property market, risk does include your tenant not paying. Ensure you work with quality agency on the property market and invest in a rent guarantee insurance and other legal products. So that's very important, and that's the risk between the stock market and the property market. So the question a lot of people ask me is, what property should I invest in? So your own home is often purchased with your heart. Investment property should be bought with your head, And that's very important. So do your research and ask for advice from seasoned investors and agents that know the market. And very important is location, location, location. Buy in the right location. Make sure of the location of all the amenities in the area, schools in the areas, and all of that is very important. And then the type of property you buy must match your investment strategy. So expensive properties, often it's more difficult to find tenants on the expensive properties, where on the lower priced properties might give you lower cash flows, but you have a wider tenant base to choose from. This lesser chance of vacancies, very important. Just to do a comparison between the property market and the stock market. If you had 1 million rand to invest in the stock market, you would have needed 1 million rand in cash. You invested it in the stock market. Let's say that capital growth of that money is 30%, that's 300,000 rand. So your value on your money would have grown with 300,000, so it's 1.3 million rand on the stock market. But you would have needed cash to invest in the stock market. Let's say you can borrow 1 million rand in the property market. You borrowed 1 million rand on the property market. Your capital growth on 30%, 300,000 rand, 1.3 million rand. You haven't invested a cent on that property of your own money. And then your tenant paid you 8,333 rand a month over 12 months. Will give you another 100,000 rand. That gives you a 40% return without using your own money. And that's the difference between the property market and the stock market. So how much equity do I have? So if you bought a property at 1 million rand and after 5 years is worth 1.5 million rand, your 500,000 rand is your equity. So rental, the same with your rental. If your rental is in year one is 8,333 rand a month, it escalates with 8% per year. This is higher than inflation, usually higher than inflation. Your rental in 5 years will be 12,243 rand and 89 cents. That gives you that additional money above the 8,333 rand, that's your equity in the property, that's your equity in the rental income that you would receive, and that will grow every year as your rental income goes up. Your tenant pays more every year and your rental income goes up. So if you bought five properties 5 years ago, you would have been 2.5 million rand wealthier and you would have not used your own money. Now that is wealth creation. Go read the books of Robert Kiyosaki, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and it will show you how to invest in property and not use your own money. Cheers.